Hey guys, this is going to be my boiling the snares video. I got my little wax and Vaseline disc there that I'm going to start my fire with, but I don't know if you can see this. Yeah, all that undissolved in there is baking soda, and I probably used, out of a box, I probably used about maybe an inch worth. I covered the bottom fully and put a little bit extra in there. So as soon as I get the fire going and that water boiling, then I will go ahead and drop them in. And I'm going to keep one cable, one of these new cables out. That way you can really get a good idea of the difference, because all you want to do is kill the shine. Okay, I'll catch you in a few. Okay guys, this is, I've got my water where it's boiling a little bit, and that's where all the action is going to take place to knock the shine off of those. Now as far as time frames or anything like that, I really cannot give you a time frame. I don't know how well that shows up. I just banked my stove as full as I can, and then what I will do now is I will go in and basically I will let that boil. And if the water boils out, I may dump in just a little bit more water. I might bring it up to, say 3/4 of the can. I did add some more baking soda. I would just say buy a small, one of those smaller boxes of baking soda. It doesn't have to be Arm & Hammer. I don't think the kind matters a bit. But just use one box for your snares if you decide to do this. You can't use too much. I don't know that you can use not enough either. I've never had them not come out right. I did set this piece of cable back. That way I can give you a side-by-side comparison. And then I will show you these when they're done, and we'll take it from there. But I went ahead and threw in all my cable that I had, except for that one piece. I thought I was going to boil it, and mainly I wanted to see if I could knock the rust off of some of that other cable that I had, that smaller diameter cable. But, okay, I will get back with you when this is all, I'm all done with it, and show you the side by side, and you guys can either try it for yourself and see what you think or whatever. But I know for me, I like it. And these snares are, they're heavy enough to where you can, if you're actually stuck someplace and you need food and there's deer around or whatever, you could definitely get you some food with them. And like I say, I do have a video that I'm planning on doing so that I can show you, what kind of habitat I look for when I am getting ready to set my snares. So I will get with you after a bit. Check this out. Yep. What an asshole. That's a little spike. I don't know if you can see his little tiny horn. Jesus Christ. Man, that's a good thing I have a tripod, because I can't run a video for shit without it. All right, guys. I'll let you go. Thanks for subscribing, watching, commenting. It really makes a difference. I know, to the people that do a lot of videos, you know, it's kind of nice to know that somebody does watch and they appreciate what you do. But thanks again, everybody. I'll catch you on the follow-up. Bye. Hey guys, I just took all these out of the out of my boil, and I think that picks up the difference. I mean, even my washers, I did all my washers. I normally don't do that, but just for fun I did today. That's what the end result looks like. This is what it looks like brand new, and that's what they look like after the fact. I boiled these rusty ones thinking I might get rid of some of that rust, but that didn't happen, so no big deal. I'll just run those. More than likely, if I was going to set those, I would set them on a barbed wire fence where coyotes or whatever is going through. But that is the this is the last video of what I do to boil snares. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Hope maybe it helps somebody out. Again, thanks to everybody that watches my videos, subscribes, comments, everything like that. Thanks, guys. Bye.